Hello, today is Wednesday, April the 7th. I'm so glad that you have joined me once again for our daily devotional. When was the last time you got pulled over by the police, the cops behind you? Has it been a long time, or are you the type of person with a lead foot, or maybe you've never been pulled over? I have, and I'll tell you, there's nothing like getting your heart rate going when you see those lights behind you, because you know you've either been going too fast, or maybe you don't know what you've done, but you know that, you know, it can't be anything good, and you just know that something bad is probably about to happen, and you start to go through your head, you know, what was I doing? Now, I let you in on a little bit of a pet peeve of mine. I used to really, really get upset when I heard that people would get warnings rather than tickets. Yeah, that's right. I would just get so frustrated when friends or family would tell me, oh, I was going 8 miles over the speed limit, I got pulled over, but it's fine, I got a warning. That used to drive me crazy because for the first, I don't know, 6, 7, 8 years of my driving livelihood, every time I got pulled over, and it wasn't that many times, but it was 2 or 3 times, I'd get pulled over for speeding, and I would just try and figure out some way to convince that officer to be kind, to be gracious, and to just let me off, you know, just let me off with the warning. And every single time I wasn't able to pull it off. I'm not sure if it was because, you know, I was just some punk kid, or the cop looked at me and thought, you know, he deserves a ticket. But whatever it was, every single time I got a ticket rather than a warning. And I heard about, you know, Corey, my girlfriend at the time, who's now my wife, she had this way of just getting off with warnings, and it drove me nuts. I thought, oh yeah, here's a pretty girl, and she gets off with this warning, and here's this dutz of a guy, and he gets a ticket. However, there is a running joke, and I'm going to let you in on this, when it comes to pastors, that pastors have this concept that if you ever get pulled over, there is a get-out-of-ticket-free card. And pastors joke about this, although I've never heard of a pastor actually doing this, but if you get pulled over and you're a pastor, you just whip out this, and if you know what that is, this is your collar that pastors would wear when they're wearing their clerics. And if you get pulled over and you're not already wearing this, you just take it out your car and you pop it in and you say you're a pastor, you're going to get off right away. Now, I'm not sure if that's ever worked, but that's kind of been a running joke amongst us pastors. Now, I told you, I had always despised the concepts of getting a warning. That was until I got a warning myself. Last time I was pulled over, believe it or not, was only about 6 months ago. So I was working at Church of the Covenant, and I was visiting some parishioners outside of Philippi, and I'd never been to their place before, so I was using my cell phone, following the GPS, trying to get to their house. And in the state of West Virginia, did you know it is against the law to have your cell phone out, even if you're using the GPS? And so I'm driving downtown Philippi, and I see those lights behind me, the police car. And truth be told, I didn't know what I was doing. You know, I didn't know that holding my GPS, trying to find a place that I was trying to find, was against the law. But sure enough, the police officer comes up and tells me it's against the law here in West Virginia, and goes back to his car, takes my driver's license, the whole process starts. And as he's sitting back there, you know, I've got this plan in my mind. I'm going to tell him, you know, I'm a pastor at the Church of the Covenant. I'm going to visit some parishioners, which I was hoping, praying that I would get off with a warning, and it worked. He let me off with a warning, and I was able to go about my day. Now, I was very, very, very thankful in that moment, but truth be told, I deserved that ticket, didn't I? I didn't deserve that warning. I was doing something that was unsafe. I was doing something that was against the law. I was doing something, truth be, the members of the church gave me a step-by-step guide to get to their house. I didn't need my phone, and I was doing something that deserved a ticket. However, what I got was something better than I deserved. Jesus Christ, has this habit of treating us better than we deserve, of giving us more grace, more kindness, more compassion, treating us better than we deserve. The Bible passage I'll read to you comes to us as Jesus is on the cross. From Luke, the 23rd chapter, beginning in verse 32. Two others who were criminals were led away to be put to death with Jesus. Now when they came to the place which is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there. There with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And this prayer is for the soldiers, for the guards on the ground as they are mocking him. They are taunting him. They are teasing him. They cast lots to divide Jesus' clothing. And the people stood by watching, but the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others, let him save himself, if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one." The soldiers also mocked Jesus, coming up and offering him sour wine, saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." I've always wondered, these guards, these people whose their day-to-day was to execute criminals on these crosses. Jesus wasn't the only one to die on the cross. This was a much-used form of execution for the Romans, and I'm sure these men were used to hearing cries and pain and anguish and maybe mocks and maybe curse words back at the guards as they watched these criminals die on the cross. And I've always wondered, when Jesus cries out, not with cries of profanity, not with mocking the soldiers, but rather he cries out, "Father, forgive them, forgive the guards, for they don't know what they're doing." I wonder how much that stuck with them throughout their lives, whether that kept them up at night as they watched this man have forgiveness on them. But Jesus has this way of doing this, doesn't he? Finding the good inside of us. And he calls out to God the Father to forgive these criminals because they didn't know what they're doing. And they truly didn't know what they were doing. They didn't know that this was the Christ, this was the Messiah that they were killing. I don't even think that they knew that Jesus was an innocent man. And Jesus, without even the criminals asking for forgiveness, goes to God and ask God to take mercy, to take compassion upon them. And then there's the criminal next to Jesus. There's two criminals. One criminal is just nothing but insults to Jesus, and the other criminal begins to insult him at first, but then in that moment comes the realization of just who Jesus is, that this man is different, that this man is not like us, that this man doesn't deserve it. And Jesus has compassion. He has mercy on this man, even though this man, this criminal, his whole life was nothing but rotten. And he truly deserved to die that death on the cross, this criminal. And yet Jesus says to him, today you will be in paradise with me. Friends, Jesus has this habit of looking at us and looking at our lives and the things that we do, and not giving us what we deserve. You know, like that police officer, when we do bad things, we deserve the ticket. Jesus is the same way. We deserve wrath. We deserve the consequences of our sins. We deserve everything that we have coming our way for all the crud that we've done in our life. But our Messiah, our Lord, has this knack, has this way of trying to find those spots in our lives where he can offer us that grace, he can offer us that forgiveness, and he gives it to us in abundance. Tomorrow, we begin our voyage into the holiest 3 days of our church year. Tomorrow's Monday, Thursday, and Friday is Good Friday. May you be blessed. May you just be overcome by this grace, this love, this compassion that is found in Jesus Christ of Nazareth. He gives us better, much better than we deserve. Amen.